Hello everyone, breaking headline parody story report entertainment show. Lindsay Lohan, the Hollywood actress, is making my show today. And I'm Rodney Dangerfield's cousin. Y'all know my cousin. I've got a great show coming up about Lindsay Lohan. The judge has ordered her to see a psychiatrist. And she says she don't have the money to pay for a psychiatrist. I don't know. I think a psychiatrist in California now, I know it'd be over $100 an hour. Might be $300 or $400 an hour. I'm not sure, but I know it's over $100 an hour. I know that. But anyways, I've got all the tips that a psychiatrist can give her, and I'm fixing to put it in my show. It's in my show. But before I go any further, you know, Lindsay Lohan has been getting in some trouble with the law. She apparently is naive about the white man's law, and I'm fixing to, you know, help her with my show. But I want to tell you my disclaimer before I go any further. Everything in my parody entertainment show is a parody. Some of the names have been changed to protect the innocent and the guilty, and some of the pictures have been changed to protect the innocent and the guilty. And do not take anything I say seriously. It's a parody, and I'm a professional. No amateur should ever try anything I say. If you disagree with my disclaimer, get your happy ass off my channel immediately. I don't want you to hear anything I gotta say. And now I want to get back to this Lindsay Lohan. A girl I know had gone to the jail, they call it the workhouse or penal institution. And, you know, she did 3 years, and she come out and she was saying, "Rodney Dangerfield, cousin, they told me that I need to change my 3 P's, playmates, playgrounds, and play friends." And I will give Lindsay Lohan the same advice. It's change your playmates, playgrounds, and play friends. And Lindsay, if you email me to my account, I'll give you some free advice personally. I can't tell you everything I would tell you if we was in a personal conversation. I'm limited to what I can tell you, but I want to tell you this, Lindsay. Do not go to a bad area of town, because the police are trained that if you go to a bad area of town, they look at you and they say, "This person's not, this girl is not supposed to be in this bad area of town. We're worried for her." And they will think you bought dope and maybe you did, you know, but they will think you bought dope. And so anyways, don't go to a bad area of town. And another thing, don't do any drugs. The white man has outlawed it, and marijuana is illegal, and it's a stepping stone to more powerful dope like crack cocaine, heroin, LSD. It's a stepping stone. People will say, "Oh, I smoked some real good weed, some pot, man, it's real good." And you know, I don't think it's that bad for you, but the problem is the white man has outlawed that over 50 years ago. It's been outlawed. It's illegal. And if you do it, chances are the government will catch you. You know, I go to a casino, and I've been going to these casinos since 92, and I've done got pulled over in roadblocks around 13 or 14 times. They asked me for my driver's license, proof of insurance. I show it to them. They say, "Have a nice day, Rodney Dangerfield's cousin. Have a nice day." If I don't have it, or if I got weed or drinking in my car, you know, they wouldn't tell me to have a nice day. They'd lock me up. So Lindsay Lohan, you know, you probably know this, but don't hang around with the type of people that come from the bad area of town. They hate you, they're haters, and they're bullies. They don't want you to say, "Your president, y'all, us, them, dude, buddy." It's probably 300 words. They will attack you and kill you if you say them. They're haters. They don't want you to say these words. And I got more for you, but I can't tell it all to you on this show. Now, if you're willing to email me, and I'll give you my phone number, you can call me. I'd like to talk to you. But it's very important that, number one, don't drink anymore. Don't smoke weed. Don't do any type of drugs. Don't even take an aspirin. Don't do nothing that the white man has outlawed. Now, that's my advice to you. And psychiatrists, they may charge you $30,000, $40,000, $100,000. They're not even going to tell you the don'ts that I told you don't do. That's where your problems are. And don't steal nothing. Don't shoplift. Right now, there's cameras on you. There's cameras everywhere. You can't get away with it, especially in this day and age and time. And being that you're a well-known figure, you can't get away with it. Anyways, I want to tell you just a minute about who I am. I'm Rodney Dangerfield's cousin. You know my cousin. He don't get no respect. Seemed like after he died, the monkey jumped on my back. I don't get any respect. I'm 63 years old now. I went to buy me a pack of cigarettes, and a bitch boy carded me. I said, "Hey, pal, I'm 63 years old." Then I went to get me a six-pack of beer. Another bitch boy carded me. I said, "Hey, I'm 63 years old." Bitch boy carded me. Then I went to get me some food at a family restaurant. Another bitch boy was behind the counter. And I said, "Hey, pal, I want my senior citizens discount." He carded me. I don't get no respect. I took my wife to a dude ranch. She left me for a black dude. My wife turned gay on me. And one day my wife and I was fixing to make love, and she's just on the bed with legs in a figure four position. And, you know, she was in a deep stare. I said, "Honey, what's wrong? You can't think of anyone to fantasize who you had sex with?" She said, "No." And people ask me, "Why would your wife leave you for a black dude?" I go, "I guess she wanted to get back with her own color." But my wife was a bully. She didn't want me to say, "You people, y'all, us, them, dude, buddy, dear, honey, sweetie, baby." She said, you racist. And you know the racial slur word they call each other? She'd go to sleep. I'm going to say the word nickel. She'd go to sleep going, "My nickel, my nickel, my nickel, my nickel." She'd be saying the real word. She'd call her friends, "My nickel, dog, dog, shit, shit bag, shit head, shit face, nappy headed fool, nappy headed hoe." I'd say, "Why you got to do that?" She said, "That's a black thing. We can do that." I divorced her. And then I went on freepornphonesex.com. It's a girl say, "Hey, lover boy, I'm having a party in my mouth. Would you like to come?" And got my dingling excited. Then I called live service. She said, "My voice is too ugly for her to talk to." Then I went to freebuysaletradeanything.com. I put a 55 Chevy on there. Once you put it on there one time, it'll keep reposting for 30 days or indefinitely until you sell it. Then I went on the personal section of that company, and I put an ad. I was looking for a Christian girl. A young white girl contacted me. We're deeply in love, and we make love three or four times a day. She's 21 years old. Our love life is going perfect. I'll never marry another black girl. They're bullies. They're haters. They hate white people. That's my show. God bless you.